We're skiing on a very active volcano. In the past, we've had serious volcanic mudflows called lahars coming down through the ski field with no alarm system. So we've got quite a serious situation which we're trying to manage. These lahars, volcanic mudflows, are really hazardous. We've actually measured them at up to 90 kilometres an hour moving down the mountain, down through where people are skiing. 90 kilometres an hour is far faster than people can ski. Some people think they can ski out of it. Some people today said they can ski faster. They can't. The lahar is full of snow. It's got ash in it, some boulders. But it's going to bowl you over and drown you and smash you against rocks and stuff. So the message is all about trying to get people out of the way. So GeoNet, New Zealand's natural hazard monitoring system, has a whole lot of seismometers spread throughout the national park. Several of those have got blast detectors, little pressure sensors.
This system we've got on the mountain, EDS, or the eruption detection system, draws information from GNS equipment that's in the park, and from an eruption down to the top of the ski field, we've got about 90 seconds before it hits the ski field, and so people need to react really quickly.
So when there's an eruption, those sensors detect the data and it sends a message up here to these hubs, all these speakers, and that then sets the alarms off. The warning system consists of speakers in the three main lahar paths. So we only have speakers where people are in danger. So we've got speakers where they need to be. We haven't got speakers where they don't need to be.
Move immediately out of valley to high ground. Move immediately out of valley to high ground. This is a volcanic emergency. This is a volcanic emergency. A lahar is expected to pass through the sea area.
This warning system needs to be as effective as it can, and it depends on a whole lot of things. It depends on people hearing it and people knowing what to do and then doing it. This is a fantastic place to ski. There's great terrain to ski, but if you're in the bottom of the valley when there's a lahar siren going, the message to people is to get out of the valley.
So during the tests, like the one you've just seen, we have people on the ground watching what people do and how people move. And we add up the numbers of people in the risk zone at the beginning of a warning and at the end, and we look at the percentage of people who get to safety. So this graph shows the results of these observations from tests over several years. For each test, there's a proportion of people skiing who are at risk at the start of the test, and a smaller proportion who have still not got out of the way by the end of the test. And in this last year, we can see about 72% of people were at risk at the start, and a bit over 10% were at risk at the end. And it can mean anywhere from a few people to maybe 40 or 50 people are still left at risk on the ski area. We also conduct surveys of awareness of the skiers, and we ask them a range of questions, including what's the right thing to do when there's a lahar warning. And we can see in the green bars we know the proportion of people who know all of the correct actions. In the blue bar we can see about 10% of people in this year knew some of the action, but the tan bars are still in the 30 to 40% range, which concerns us. That's 30 to 40% of people who don't know what to do. We've developed a range of education materials. We have posters and brochures with hazard maps on them and warning information. We've added to that with signs added to lift towers, asking people questions about mud flows and telling them what to do. The most important message is if you're in the ski field and you hear the siren, move out of the valleys onto the ridges nearby. We're continuing to conduct communications and education research every year to come up with new ideas to further improve people's response.
The systems we have here, particularly the EDS system, is a unique system obviously in New Zealand and also around the world. We've got a number of partners that support this system, such as the Department of Conservation, GeoNet, EQ, and obviously RAL, the ski field.